Good morning, everyone. So this is Copper. He used to belong to me, and now he belongs to a friend of mine, and he is an emotional support dog for that friend. And he is in today. He had a really, really long coat at one point. We were testing some blade lengths today, so this is why that's a little bit shorter. He gets quite a few burrs and stuff in his coat, so we're going to be trimming him pretty short today, and we're just going to go ahead and get started with a bath. He weighs right at 75, 76 pounds, and he is a full brother to my parents' dog, Rusty, and he is a half brother to my parents' dog, Zach, and my standard poodle, Gus. Everything I'm using in today's video is linked down below. This is the Green Groom Odor Eliminator Shampoo. I'm going to get him all wet, and then I am going to hand scrub him just a little bit. Can you stand up? Good boy. I have not groomed him for many, 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 many months. I did give my friend some grooming supplies, and they have been doing a wonderful job. He never is matted. Okay. So, whoa, that just got bright all of a sudden. So just gonna take some shampoo and do a little bit of hand scrubbing. You guys go back, bud. There you go. Sweet boy. Ella, what are you doing? Are you booping me? Good boy. Definitely going to get his feet. In between his feet. Your foot. Did you hear that? It's a shampoo. It's just a shampoo. Okay. I'm going to turn him and turn this way. Good boy. I'm going to scoot back just a little bit. The longer the hair, usually the more dirt the coat is going to hold. Just washing his tail. It's okay, bud. All back in the tub and get your head. You gotta stay in the tub, buddy. You gotta stay in the tub. Gonna rinse all this shampoo out. And we're gonna do a conditioner. You want to make sure you get all of that soap out. It's okay. Yep, can you stand up? Listen up. Gotta get all the soap out, right? If you get soap in the feet, you want to make sure that you're rinsing those feet 100%. Come over here. Just turn a little bit. Make sure you get all this out. Turn up. Nice meat boy. Okay, now I'm going to switch this to the conditioner. Getting to the very end of the conditioner that I have made, which is fine because we're almost done with that. Okay, that's done. Now we're just gonna rinse. If you do not get all the conditioner and soap out, it will make the dog look unbathed. So you want to make sure that you rinse all of that out. Boy. Move it. wash his ears quickly. Come here, bud. Come over here just a little bit. Okay. This is just dog ear cleaner. You gotta turn. And then we're just gonna do this one. Right in here. Come here. So it's a little dirty in here. There's some junk down in there. And you will see as I do this, it's going to flush all that gunk out. I know, but let me see. It's okay. Make sure I got all of it out. And I did. So you can see. So all I'm going to do is just rinse the outside of his ear and that hair off. And that's it. We're going to kind of squeegee. Squeegee a little bit and make sure we get all that water off. I'm gonna shake again. Look at those teefers. Teefers. Gonna get as much water off as possible and then we'll get him dry. Easy. Come on, let's go up here. Come on, up here. Copper, buddy, up here. Come on, come on. There you go. Good boy. Good boy. Gonna put a happy hoodie on him. Make sure that these ears are tucked against the side of his face to protect his hearing and reduce any stress or anxiety related to the dryer. So I'm just gonna spray a little bit of Shosheen. And then I'm gonna start drying him. So I have a nickname for him and it is Clifford because he is big and red. So I'm just gonna start drying him. Thank you.
Thank you. I
Fluffy. He's so cute. So I'm going to be using a 5/8. 5/8. So you can see we tested a little bit here just to see how short it would be. So I'm just going to take this off and do around his head, his neck. Oh my god,
there's a fire.
It's okay. Step on it.
On the wall.
Get your shoe and smack it. Can you do that? I gotta get him done, baby, or I would kill it for you.
Okay.
drilled from the back of the ear down. And that neckline down. Get all that hair off. So then I can put this back on him. And then we can just do the rest of his body. Just like that. Sweet boy. Stand up. You're gonna look and feel so much better. Stand up. He does have man parts, so you gotta be careful down there. Good boy, can you sit? Sit. Good boy. Good boy. Just gonna work on his chest area. So on here, I'm just going to take this brush. Just brush backwards and run this through that. And definitely we need to do some hand scissoring. That's okay. Come over here. Nope, we're not getting down yet. Not getting down yet, bud. You have so much hair. Yeah, so much hair. You know that? Oh, I love him so much. So, same thing. Turn this up. Boy. And he is an example as to why it is super important to start dogs early, ideally at 6 to 8 weeks old, and about every 2 weeks until they're 6 months old, and then going to a every month schedule or every 6 week schedule. Started him just like I did my boy Gus, and he started young. He also grew up in shop, so he was around all the noises and everything every day. Take this, push this up. boy. So I am going to have to raise this table up a little bit, which I don't want to have to do, but I got to be able to reach his feet. So I'm going to use this dryer and blow this off real quick. Fluffy hair. One trick that I love is just to go back with the dryer and fluff that hair up some more, and it, that haircut will just look so much cleaner if you just run over it one more time when that hair is all fluffed up. Boy. Okay, now one more time, just get this off. Go ahead and do his nails. No, don't step off. No. No, sir. Okay, I'm gonna do this one. Good boy. No. Copper. Okay, can you sit? You can sit. Sit. Good boy. No. No, sir. Come here, bud. It's okay. Okay. Good boy. No. Okay. such a good boy. I'm gonna work on his tail. Up. Since he's got a short cut, we want to do a pretty short tail, or it won't look proportional to his body. So you can see where this line is. We're just going to take off those odd hairs. And we're gonna comb through it again. Find the end of his tail, and I want to trim all this off. I want it to look proportional. Fluff it up a little bit. Anything that's sticking out that looks funny, we're just going to trim it. This side and do the same thing. Good boy. To look proportional to the body.
What tail is that called? Is that a lion tail?
Mm. So it looks like just trimming it up so it looks proportional to his body.
Oh, looks like a lion tail.
Looks like a lion tail?
Yeah.
Kinda, huh?
Yeah. It actually looks like a cheeto.
It does kind of look like a cheetah tail, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
A cheeto.
Cheeto. A cheeto.
Yes.
You're goofy.
A Cheeto.
So I'm going to take my thinning shears now, and I'm just going to clean up. For anyone new here, this is my daughter, Kelby. She's homeschooled.
Can I vacuum all this up?
Yeah, when I get done, you can vacuum it up.
Because it looks like a pigsty.
Looks like a pigsty, huh?
Yeah.
So I'm just going to trim up all this fringe, make it look a little bit neater. We don't want any loose hairs sticking out. What you think, mister? Buzz Lightyear?
Yeah.
Okay. So I am going to take just this guard off because there's a 30 blade underneath, and then I'm going to trim this paw pad. Clean that up. Then all I'm going to do is brush this down, and then I'm just going to trim.
How do you do that?
You just push the button and it turns it off.
Does it like send a message to it?
Yeah, Bluetooth.
Like
Like how your headphones work?
And no, like how if you want to print something and it's on a computer, you just press that button and it tells the printer?
Yes.
Oh, that's amazing. You don't even have to push the button.
These feet pretty short because of grass seeds and stuff.
Copper's leaning on me. Copper's leaning on me.
Get that hair in between. Just like that.
So how can you see the comments?
I'm not live.
Oh. I thought you were.
Huh. I'm recording.
Oh.
Yeah, this is not live. This is just recording. So I can edit it later.
What?
You're funny. Trying to see where your hand is?
Yeah. Oh, there it is.
So, same thing. I don't know. Is it?
I think it is. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I think it is. How can you still on the camera thing when you're not live?
So I can make sure that it's where they can see. Stay. Such a good boy. Good boy. Same thing with this. I'm just gonna turn up this paw pad. Thank you.
You hear her, Copper? What is she doing? What is she doing? Blowing on something? What are you blowing on?
The fire lamp.
Oh. Take a bunch of this bulk off. So they're not so bulky and long. Cutting his feet quite short. They grow really fast, and feet are the number one place where stickers like to stick, because it's the feet are in the grass the whole time. So paintbrush, sweet. Yeah.
What was that space puzzle thing?
Space puzzle. In the drawer.
The drawer.
So, just gonna do the same thing. Gonna clean out this foot. Sorry if you can't see, but let's do this real quick. Okay, and we're just going to do the same thing. Trim all this up back here. And again, trim short. Okay, so now the only other main thing that I need to do is trim his sanitary area. I'm gonna start with a 7 because I just don't wanna cut him too close. So just gonna have a 7 here and just going to trim all this up. That's pretty good. Hasn't been trimmed in a long time. All I'm going to do now is just kind of trim up back here, kind of blend it a little bit better. Good boy. All that is left is his head, and we want his head to match his body, and we are going to be trimming his ears a little bit. So I'm going to start with a 1-inch guard. That's not taking much off at all. So I actually think I'm gonna leave it at this level. I think if we go any shorter, it's gonna be too short. So I did do quite a bit of trimming on him. My dad called. My mom has some health problems going on that are pretty significant that she just got diagnosed with, and so I had to talk to him. And so I've just kind of been trimming on him while I was talking and just getting him nice and squared away. I'm gonna trim these ears just straight across. Clean up around his ear quite a bit, right in here. I just want to clear all that out so the ear can breathe. And just go ahead and trim this side too. Do the same thing. Can you sit? I know, you're ready to go. We're almost done. Sit. 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 Good boy. Clean this up a little bit right here. Be able to see for quite a while. And then we want to trim all this up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to brush this up like so. Make sure you hold the mouth firmly. So we're not cutting the tongue. Nope. Put all that, trim it, and then looks more like a puppy. Just like that. Just going to make sure that this is all evened up. Set it just a little bit more. And I think he is good to go. He's such a cute boy. Just going to get him a bandana. Stay. My daughter Kelby wanted to go with Buzz Lightyear, so that's what we're gonna go with, is the Buzz Lightyear. Let's roll it up a little bit. And then put it on him. And that's it. And he's ready to go. See, we're ready to go. Aren't you? Hang on. We're gonna do a little bit of spray. What's this? Some mouth spray. Most dogs do not like that. And I am going to dose his ears also real quick. And that's it. Handsome boy. He's ready to go. You ready to go? You ready?